Hello, it's Peter Bradshaw here. Welcome to this new vlog, as crisp and fresh as a newly baked croissant from a stylish Parisian brasserie. And it's time for one of the films of the year. It's Steven Spielberg's passionate revival of West Side Story, starring Ansel Elgort and newcomer Rachel Zegler, as the star-crossed lovers Tony and Maria from the different gangs, the Jets and the Sharks.
I know now I was right, for here you are, and what was just a world, there's a star tonight.
It was only when I watched this that I realised I've been singing that tune, along with I Want to Be in America, under my breath all my life. Basically, this film is an ecstatic act of ancestor worship on Spielberg's part, vividly dreamed, cunningly modified, and visually amazing. He has worked with his longtime script collaborator, Tony Kushner, to change Arthur Lawrence's book, to tilt the emphases and create long stretches of unsubtitled Spanish dialogue. And this, together with more authentic Latino casting, brings the movie more aligned with contemporary sensibilities, while at the same time being more faithfully trad. The eerily convincing digital recreations of 1950s New York, together with the film's theatricality, make this whole thing hyper-real, as if you have somehow hallucinated your way back 70 years onto the Broadway stage for the opening night, and the city streets outside. Rita Moreno, who played Maria's cousin Anita in the original 1961 movie, is now given a small role as Tony's landlady Valentina, although I should say that Richard Boehmer, who was Tony in the first movie, and much later starred in Twin Peaks, is sadly not given a cameo. Elgort and Zegler are, for me, a more real pairing than Boehmer and Natalie Wood in the original, but they, importantly, all four have the same fundamental unironized innocence and quaint pre-pop, pre-youth culture, late 50s unworldliness. West Side Story is an exotic hothouse flower of musical theatre, and Steven Spielberg rightly doesn't disguise its stage origins. His mastery of technique is thrilling, and I gave my heart to this American fairy tale of doomed love. It's time to discuss the creepiest and weirdest movie of the week, Lamb, directed by the Icelandic filmmaker Valdimar Jóhannsson, starring Noomi Rapace. Noomi Rapace and Hilmir Snergudnason play Maria and Ingvar, a stressed and unhappy married couple who have a farm in Iceland. They have recently lost a child and they are deeply lonely and depressed. And then one terrible night, a strange spiritual visitation descends on the barnyard like a demonic whirlwind, scaring the horses, and one of the ewes becomes pregnant. And the outcome of that pregnancy, the unholy lamb of not God in the title, is to change the couple's lives. It's only when you get to see what it is we're talking about here that the black comedy of the movie kicks in, which is hilarious, and it means that you, the audience, can relax and lean into the bizarreness of all that's happening. Although it does also mean that some of the realism and the subtlety of the performances get upstaged, and you might even find yourself almost resenting the coyness with which the film had up until now withheld these money shot images. There is great animal acting here to go with the great human acting and the great prosthetic creature effect acting, if that's a thing. It's a very startling parable of loneliness or a symbolic anti-miracle redeeming humanity's alienation from nature. But it doesn't have to be metaphorical. It could just be a scary movie about a lamb. Great stuff from Noomi Rapace anyway. Her best work in ages. That's it. Please, if you haven't already done so, have some respect for yourself and hit that subscribe button harder and more fervently than you've ever done anything before in your life. And if you're looking for Christmas presents, call off the search, because there's my book entitled The Films That Made Me, which you really should get your debit card out for. Be seeing you.